In the vast expanse of the American West, where ecosystems bear the scars of time, natural forces, and human intervention, a beacon of hope emerges. The Bureau of Land Management, with funds provided by the Inflation Reduction Act, has embarked on an initiative to breathe new life into the landscape. A monumental $161 million investment from Congress and the White House is flowing into 21 ecosystems designated for restoration across 11 states, laying the groundwork for a transformative journey. In the rugged stretches of southern Arizona, specifically the Sky Islands, snow-capped peaks rise thousands of feet as they emerge from a valley floor where the San Pedro River struggles to flow year-round. As diverse as they are breathtaking, the Sky Islands contain a remnant of natural grasslands that have existed for millennia. Over the last 150 years, the lands have become fragmented by settlement and development, by agriculture and infrastructure, reducing the amount of important wildlife habitat.
The San Pedro is one of the last free-flowing rivers in the Southwest. Species in our hemisphere depend on this place to get from their summer ranges to their winter ranges. Those are mostly the songbirds, millions of them, that use this as their travel way during migration. These are the connecting tissue of those different islands that are so isolated from one another. And that's why we see so much animal movement through these places. They really depend on them to be able to get from one high elevation range to another.
Working on behalf of the community, Holly Richter spends a lot of time on the banks of the San Pedro. Her research focuses on managing groundwater to ensure ecosystem resilience. She calls this river the lifeblood of the Sky Islands. In the border town of Sierra Vista, Richter collaborates with local leaders and the BLM to retain and eventually increase the amount of groundwater critical to the people who live here.
How we manage groundwater outside the boundaries of the riparian area is very important. And so we work very closely and collaboratively with BLM, who provides essential funding for our partners to be able to do the science about the groundwater that feeds the San Pedro so that we can work across boundaries. All of the things that need to happen to keep this vital ecosystem healthy requires really strong partnerships and strong science and adequate funding. And we're just really lucky to have BLM's funds to pull all that together.
But what's so cool about this is it's always changing.
About 40 miles north in the town of Sonoyta, Arizona, we meet rancher Ian Tomlinson. His work to restore the land has been a top priority for decades. Partnering with the BLM, he is scaling up these efforts.
We have a thing called biological planning where we get together with all the stakeholders.
At Tomlinson's Vera Earl Ranch, sustainability isn't just a buzzword. It's a way of life. Against the backdrop of changing climate patterns, Tomlinson and his team reflect the resilience of Southern Arizona's ranching community. Through adaptive practices and a commitment to conservation, they aim to steward the land responsibly, leaving it better for future generations.
We talk about a core set of values. You have a core set of values within your company that stretches out how you treat people, how you treat the public, how you treat the people that work for you. And so we've always grown with those in mind. And, you know, any type of growth that we do, if we can do it keeping those core values in place, then we do it. It's a slower growth, but I think it's a much more richer, fulfilling growth.
In this part of Arizona, this unprecedented investment signals a turning point, a renewed commitment to a more resilient and inclusive future, one where the richness of these natural resources and many uses of the land are known for generations to come.
We're not making any more land, so we better figure out how to utilize, sustain, protect, keep the land we have. There's lots of stuff we can build, but we're not building any more of this.